So it is made official, Luis Ortiz versus Deontay Wilder, November 4th. And I couldn't be happier. And I never doubted Deontay Wilder, never for a second. Never will I doubt the guy. I think it goes amiss by many of his critics that Deontay Wilder is a pretty forthcoming individual. It's one of the reasons why I support him. That and the fact that he puts a lot of his time and effort in the community. He's a very down-to-earth individual. And he's one of those guys that you can tell that the money doesn't mean anything to him. It's winning. I think that also goes overlooked. And so to Deontay Wilder, having to deal with the Bermaine Stiverne situation, handling that, knowing how important it is to the heavyweight division that there be one champion, one name attached to it, I absolutely have to commend him for this. I also have to give Luis Ortiz credit and respect. Thank you, Luis Ortiz, for making this fight as well, because you could have easily went a different direction, a different route. Many were speculating you would. I myself speculated that you would, but you didn't, and you made this fight for the fans, and I appreciate this wholeheartedly, 100%. Now it's time to get down to get to the nitty-gritty. To the Deontay Wilder, I want to say obsessive critics, you guys have to walk a tightrope. And the reason why I say that is that narrative that he hasn't fought anybody, that he's the weak heavyweight in the division, his legs. What else have we heard the common thing? Who has he fought to get a shot at Anthony Joshua? Your excuses are running out and they're running thin. And this is what happens when you use false narratives to protect a fighter that you are emotionally attached to. And that's really what it comes down to. A lot of it is emotion. You know, particularly in boxing, you find boxing fans, they will attach themselves to a fighter and they pour all their emotional effort into, I don't want to say protect that fighter, but give that fighter leeways. And this is what's happened when it came to Anthony Joshua. A lot of, after he beat Klitschko, I was actually talking and defending Anthony Joshua. And I actually was rooting for Anthony Joshua before he beat Klitschko, by that ad. I had the videos as track record. And then Joshua beat Klitschko, you saw overnight this exponential growth of Anthony Joshua fans, and they were coming to people's videos and telling people that Deontay Wilder ain't shit. And it just was like overnight out of hand. Because what it is that a lot of times people who really don't watch the sport and they watch it for like the main events, you become emotionally invested in the guy that gets you excited when you're watching him fight, him or her fight, depending if you're watching MMA or boxing. And you don't really know about the division in which this fighter who's exciting you at the moment is fighting in. You don't know the opponents. And so you immediately latch on to that fighter, and then you start to make excuses for that fighter. And you say things. It's okay. It's a human element to the boxing game, to shit, hell, to combat sports, to sports in general. You know, a fan is just a shortened word for a fanatic, okay? And listen, we understand that, okay? But now is the time that people need to start really choosing their words very, very wisely, because time's running out, all right? Anthony Joshua is going to fight Pulev, and he's going to beat Pulev. I actually believe that Anthony Joshua should beat Pulev very easily. I know some people think Pulev is this tactician, and I don't see where you see that. He's pretty pedestrian up and down. Then Deontay Wilder, to Deontay Wilder. Let me put it that way, okay? This is going to be my two-parter to this video. This is going to be my message to Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder, I have supported you since you have come on the scene since day one. And I have seen your growth as a fighter. I've seen your growth as a man. I've seen your growth as a person, okay, who wants to be an ambassador to the heavyweight division. Now you must perform. Now you must put together. What you did against Bermaine Stiverne is not going to be enough. You're going to have to elevate your game again to another level. All right? And you're going to have to knock Luis Ortiz out. If it goes to a decision, Deontay Wilder, it will not be looked at as a good enough victory because your critics will use that and say, well, they can say whatever, put it that way. All right? I'm not going to interject what I think they'd say, but they could say whatever. You never want to leave doubt in the hands of your critics because doubt, Deontay Wilder, is the biggest weapon in boxing that can be used to keep you away from your ultimate goal. Sorry, excuse me. So Deontay, from Questex to you, I believe in you. I know that you have the heart of a champion, the heart of a warrior, and you really want to win this fight. So you need to go out there on November 4th with all of your family and your friends and your fan base, all of Alabama on your back. Go out there and land that thunderous right hand and put Luis Ortiz on the canvas. To Luis Ortiz, my message to you is, I appreciate what you've meant to the heavyweight division, being the boogeyman and the scariest man in the division. But unfortunately, Deontay Wilder needs that head. He needs your head on a platter. He needs to charge in to the negotiation tables with Anthony Joshua, letting Anthony Joshua know that when they step in the ring, it ain't gonna be easy. It's your boy Questex. I'm out. Peace.